NASCAR returns to the streets of Exhibition Place as the Toronto Indy celebrates its 30th anniversary. 26 of the country's best stock car drivers are set to do battle in the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto.
The NASCAR Canadian Championship has been a dogfight as veteran skilled racers match wits with the fearless youth as the series moves from tight ovals to technical road courses. Now the muscle of NASCAR speeds into Toronto. Canada's biggest city hosts the nation's talent as NASCAR Pinty Series takes on the six. Hello, everyone, and welcome. I'm Dave Bradley. Along with me is Adam Ross. Todd Lewis is patrolling the pits for us here today. Adam, we've had a little bit of a hiatus here in Toronto, but we're back on the streets of Exhibition Place.
Dave, it's a three-year deal between NASCAR and the event promoters. The race teams want to be here, and soon the grandstands behind us will be filling up with race fans hungry for stock car action. It's a win-win.
And it is a busy, really a weekend of racing here on the grounds of Exhibition Place, and it's pretty much the same track we saw back in 2011. There's been some minor tweaks and changes. The pit road has gone from one side of the track to the other, and getting there is a little different as well. Turns 10 and 11 now a series of tight S-bends.
And tight is the word. It is a skinny part of the racetrack, but our drivers are the best there are. I can tell you one thing, they're not going to be racing side by side through this part of the racetrack.
And one driver who adapted very quickly to those changes. No surprise here. The number 27 Dodge of Andrew Ranger, the man from Roxton Pond, Quebec, captured his 18th career E3 spark plugs pull. That's a series record in a time of 117.912.
Qualifying was a back-and-forth affair. Andrew Ranger and Alex Tagliani both took turns at the top of the charts. Ultimately, it was Andrew Ranger with the pole, and that's no surprise. He's been dominant on the streets of Toronto.
And he's the man with a hot hand in the series as well. He has the points lead, six markers over 16-year-old Caden Lapcevich.
And Caden Lapcevich qualified 16th. He needs to keep his nose clean, have a good top 10 result, and that'll help him in the championship battle and Johnson's Rookie of the Year standings.
And with more on today's race, let's head down trackside and say hello to Todd Lewis. Todd?
Thanks, guys. We all know what the 27 has done here on the streets of Toronto. He's led 80% of the laps in the last couple of times that we were here. Leading laps, running up front, winning races, that is the key to a championship battle. Alongside on the front row, the 18 EpiPen Chevrolet of Alex Tagliani. The former IndyCar racer has been fast and competitive. He was quickest in practice. He would like to have that lead by the time they get to corner number one. The surprise of the weekend has been in the 06 car. Carlos De Coseda is normally the driver of this car, but he injured his back, so he called on his Porsche GT3 driver, Daniel Morad, to take over the seat. And boy, did he have fun with it. Jumped out of the car after practice and said, "This is tremendous, really enjoying it." The former open wheel and Porsche GT3 standout will start third. Let's see how he does after 35 laps here in Toronto.
And Todd, talk about a steep learning curve. You go from a couple laps in practice now to the race trim. There's a good look at the CBR number 8 of Kevin Poitras.
Kevin Poitras, one of many esteemed road racers in this field today. And now let's send it down to Tony Spiteri and his Pinty's crew for the command to get things started.
Drivers, start your engines!
And the engines come to life on the streets of Toronto for the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto.
A star-studded front row for sure. Andrew Ranger alongside Alex Tagliani. There's a lot of road racing wins on the front row. We're going to have some great looks from deeper in the field as well. On board with David Thorndike's number 67 starting deep in this field.
And as the field gets set to roll off, there will be a lot of action here today because it's the first street race that we've seen so far in 2016. Caden Lapcevich has some work to do, and this is his first race with walls on both sides. Let's take a look at the Mopar starting grid.
Andrew Ranger on the pole with Alex Tagliani just a few hundredths of a second behind, starting second.
Row number two, there is Daniel Morad in the 06, Kevin Lacroix, the rookie in the 74.
Rounding out the top five was Patrick Dussault in the 71 Dodge, and starting sixth will be Alex LeBay in the 32.
The Dumoulin brothers make up row number four, LP and JF. Row number five is Kerry Mix, strong qualifying effort in the 02, Jason Hathaway in the 3.
Starting 11th, Anthony Simone in the 95, and DJ Kennington in the Castrol Edge 17. Row number number 7, a father-son affair. It's son Gary Clute in the 59 and Peter Clute in the 42.
Looking back to row number 8, there's Robin Buck in the number 1 and Caden Lapcevich in the 76. Row 9 has Matthew Skinnell in the 56. Kevin Poitras driving the 8 car here today.
To the 10th row brings us John Ferrano in the 22 and Jason White in the 21.
And row number 11, Brett Taylor in the 46, Josh Collins from Newfoundland in the 25.
Row number 12, Brian Cathcart in the 75, and there's David Thorndike in the 67.
And rounding out the field, the final row, the 87 of Larry Jackson, and there's the number 9 of Adam Martin, a Dodge and a Ford, making up that final row. As the field makes their way on pace laps in the shadow of the CN Tower, what a beautiful race facility this is.
We have a look at the E3 spark plugs race analysis for here in Toronto. It's 35 laps, another one of our sprint races on the road courses. There'll be no pit stops today, Dave.
And Adam, that always makes things interesting because it's going to be flat out right from the drop of the green to the drop of the checkered. Before we go to that green flag, let's check in with Todd with today's Leland lead up to the green. Todd?
Guys, keep an eye on the number 1 car of Robin Buck. He's starting 15th. Raced here 30 years ago in the first ever Indy weekend in the Players GM Series, finished second. He was also, of course, the winner of the first CASCAR race here on the streets of Toronto. He had some struggles during practice and qualifying, but he will be quick. Look for him to charge toward the front. One of the 5 CBRT race team cars this weekend. Joey McComb and staff really building quite a huge super team.
And the newest member is the driver of the number 21, Jason White from Sun Peaks, British Columbia, the YourGMCTruckStore.com Chevrolet, one of 9 drivers to start all races here at Toronto.
And we see how narrow the course is for Jason White's 85th start. Now it's up to the front row. Andrew Ranger will set the pace with Alex Tagliani right alongside.
Very much a feel of Trois-Rivières, Quebec, and that circuit now here in Toronto as the walls have tightened through turn 11 as they head on to the front straightaway and looking for the drop of the green flag. The field now stretches out on the front chute, looking for the green this time.
Seize the opportunity there. There'd been a lot of talk over Tagliani and Ranger drag racing into turn 1. Nobody talked about Daniel Morant beating both of them.
And Daniel Morant didn't seem to know what cold breaks. Oh, look at the 71 take a slide and a tap off the wall.
Hey, you know, I was going to talk about the temperature of the Goodyear tires. They're not up to temp yet. I believe that's what bit Daniel Morant as we go on board Jason Hathaway.
These are big, heavy cars, and when those tires are cold, the brakes are cold, they really don't handle well. And both Patrick Dussault and Daniel Morant found that out here on lap number 1.
You know, I talked to the drivers, and every one of them was concerned about turn 1 and turn 3 on the first lap. It looks like we made it through both of them pretty clean, Dave.
Kevin Lacroix continues to lead. There you saw the 76 of Caden Lapcevich as we ride on board.
And what I want you to watch today, with the concrete and asphalt combination rumble strips on the inside of the corners, Dave, watch how busy these drivers' hands are all day long.
Kevin Lacroix, your leader here on lap number 1. Andrew Ranger tucked into second, but you can see the field still jockeying for positions. There goes Simone in the innovative plumbing number 95 to the inside of the 17 Castrol Edge Dodge to DJ Kennington.
On board the Gary Clute, number 59, listen to these engines wind out down Lakeshore Boulevard, headed towards turn number 3.
And Hathaway getting a little crossways under braking as he makes a move underneath the 0-2 of Gary Mix. There's a couple veterans who have done some battling before.
He had his hands full going through that corner, managed to hang on to it and complete the pass, Dave.
Boy, everybody single file now through the tighter portion of the racetrack. Really, turn number 3 is probably your best position to pass here at Exhibition Place. There, a puff of fire from underneath the 74 of Kevin Lacroix.
And they work through those turns number 9, 10, and 11. It gets narrower and narrower. Problems for Kevin Poitras in the number 8.
The Pilotti Ford Fusion goes around. He you can see just the local caution as a couple drivers scatter to try and miss the 75. That's Brian Cathcart. He jumps hard on the brakes. There goes Watrous for the ride.
It looked as though he was on his own. Matthews Cannell was right behind him, but it didn't look like they were close enough to make contact. Fortunately for Kevin, he didn't hit anything.
His teammate Josh Collins in the eastbound speedway, number 25, making some pretty evasive action there, avoiding a collision with his teammate, making for less work as far as the fix-it team goes for CBRT.
These cars just sound awesome. Given enough time to let the engines really wind out on the Lakeshore Boulevard is Gary Clue to the inside of Alex LeMay in the 32.
Battle for 11th spot. Remember, Gary Clue does have a victory on a road course. That one coming at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. But the crew's watching on. It's all in the driver's hands now here on lap number 3. This NASCAR on TSN telecast from the streets of Toronto is brought to you by WeatherTech, the ultimate interior protection for your vehicle. By Mopar, authentic performance. And by Pinty's, making great food fun.
And they continue to battle on the streets of Toronto. Andrew Ranger hounding the leader, Kevin Lacroix. Problem for Patrick Dusso. He was running in fifth. Got out of shape. It looks like turn 3. And he's going to filter in just behind the Robin Buck number 1.
Oh, he was having such a great run after a great qualifying effort. Was running in the fifth spot. Now back into 13th. That's where he'll find his hole. But the youngster, Patrick Dusso, heartbreak early on. Of course, running the car owned by Patrice Brisebois, who's in attendance here today. And Patrice Brisebois, no slouch behind the wheel, giving the youngster some tips, but unfortunately gets into the tire wall in the early going.
Oh, big flames under the 95 of Anthony Simone. That is all through the race car.
And you can see the NASCAR official quickly getting to the window net of the Innovative Plumbing number 95. The fire goes out now, but something broke under the hood of that Dodge Challenger. There's Simone out of the car.
Man, they had that car so fast. Let's have another look. There's Simone up the inside. Under braking. Wow, that's a big
fireball.
Look
at the fire in the cockpit. You can see it inside the windshield on the 95, and Simone heads up, goes straight for pit lane.
That looks like a fuel leak, Dave.
Anthony Simone, happy to see that you are out of that car that was on fire safe. You have had such frustration this year, and you had a good run going today.
What a disappointment, man. We had such a fast car today. Had the worst luck. I don't understand it. Can't get the monkey off our back. It looks like we were up to about fifth or sixth there. And then the car just caught on fire coming out of turn 6 here. I don't know. Rough day.
Sad to see that you're out, but happy that Anthony Simone is okay.
Dave, Don Thompson Jr. was over at that shop between iCar and this race, and he worked with the crew chief, Jeff Wall, to go through a lot of things on the suspension of the race car. Anthony was very pleased that Jeff Wall was able to learn some of what Don Thompson Jr. has inside that head as we see a battle for the lead.
Yeah, Andrew Ranger taking a look to the inside of the number 74. Bumper-to-bumper Dodge Challenger of Kevin Lacroix. Now let's ride with Andrew Ranger. Two-time winner here on the streets of Toronto. You know, I mentioned it before, but I'll say it again. Just look at how calm he is.
Well, and what I love about Andrew Ranger, you never know. The place to pass at this racetrack is on the inside of turn 1 and the inside of turn 3. But nobody told Andrew Ranger. He's been working the outside groove.
And right up to the back bumper of the 74 as they exit turn number 11. This will be a good opportunity for the driver of the 27 to pass going into turn number 1. He's in the draft. He pokes it to the outside. And there's a look further back to 71. Patrick Dussault has made contact once again with the tire wall.
Yeah, a lot of body work dangling on that race car. Look at Kevin Lacroix. That car just ever so slightly in a drift between turns 1 and 2.
And take nothing away from Kevin Lacroix. He is a super road race driver here in the NASCAR Pinty Series, but now they're side by side into 3.
If Ranger can just get his right front tire ahead of the left front of Lacroix, he can dictate the line through 1 and 2. But as long as Lacroix has that edge going into the turn, he can shut the door every time.
Boy, Kevin Lacroix just said, Mr. Ranger, meet the door, because I'm slamming it in your face. But look at that. While those two have battled, these two are gaining ground. Daniel Worad and the 18 of Alex Taglianni.
And these cars just rocketing around this racetrack. You really get a sense on some of those onboards, the speed they carry.
Now, Adam, Andrew Ranger has played this game before. He has chased Kevin Lacroix last year at Surfery iCar. He played patient. He let Lacroix get well out in ahead, and then he couldn't catch him. Now, he's pressuring him at every corner. Is that just a difference of strategy here?
Well, he's showing many, many looks to Kevin Lacroix. One thing, he's not letting him get away the way he did at iCar last year. The other thing, he's shown him his bumper in at least five different corners on the racetrack.
Problems for the 17 of DJ Kennington, right in front of our broadcast position. He'll pull to the end of pit lane, but it looks like big problems for the Castrol Dodge.
Not sure what'll happen there as Ranger to the outside once again. You can see Lacroix wiggle under braking into turn three.
Does Ranger have enough to make it stick? No, he doesn't. Once again, he'll slot back in behind in the Mopar Dodge.
Right on the rear bumper of Kevin Lacroix's number 74 as they work through the tight turns. Kevin Lacroix makes one small bobble and Andrew Ranger's going to capitalize, Dave.
You know what? We talked about off the top of the show how dominant Andrew Ranger has been here on the streets of Toronto. He has led 62 of 73 laps coming into this event. And right now, he is chasing, running second.
Big move by Ranger there to the inside. We said there'd be no passing in this part of the racetrack, and there was Ranger having a look, Dave.
And there you see the problems on the 17 of DJ Kennington.
And the window net goes down. That is certainly not a good sign. Of course, neither is the smoke billowing out from under the hood.
Remember, he comes into this one third in points, elevating that status last race. But he's out on this one, and that's going to hurt him in the point standings as we look at this battle at the top of the field. Fourth place, Alex Taglianni.
Here goes Ranger to the inside. He tried the outside. Now he's down low all over the place.
And braking, he got crossways and now into the lead. Here comes the 06 of Daniel Worad, looking to make a move for second.
Worad takes advantage of their battle. He'll look to the inside.
Off the curb and off of Kevin Lacroix. And now Morad's going to fall back. Here comes Taglianni, the EpiPen Chevy.
Every time you make a move in a race car, Dave, there's every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So you get someone off their racing line, that creates an opportunity for the next guy in line. So these top four staying this close together, every time one of them makes a move, the one behind them is going to try something. It may not work, but they're going to try.
And Daniel Worad just learned a valuable lesson of racing in the NASCAR Pinty Series, that everything is so tight and things happen very, very quickly as he now sits in fourth spot. Andrew Ranger is your new leader, but one driver who's out is the driver of the Castrol Edge Dodge. Todd?
Frustrating day for DJ Kennington. You battled through brake issues yesterday. What's the problem today?
And just coming through turn nine, looks like we broke a spindle in the Castrol Edge Dodge. I mean, one of those days, you know, I feel bad for our sponsors, but we'll be back next week. We'll go get him in Edmonton.
DJ Kennington going to make some repairs before they head out west. Tough day. He was third in points, guys. This is going to be a big hit.
And there is his team car, the Mopar Dodge of Andrew Ranger, starting to open up a gap now at the front of the field as the master goes to work. He's in the lead. Andrew Ranger here in Toronto. Welcome back to the NASCAR Pinty Series on TSN and the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto. There you see a battle for sixth spot between the 02 of Kerry Mix and the number 3 of Jason Hathaway.
Ever so slowly, Kerry Mix has been doing a great job bringing that road course program back up towards where it used to be. He used to be a main player at every road racing event we went to.
And he has that 02, the Avenue Auto Parts Ford Fusion singing here in Toronto for sure as Kevin Lacroix starts to work through lap traffic. The racer's number 9 of Adam Martin jumps up to the outside to let the faster drivers through.
Adam Martin had problems in that Johnsonville number 9 throughout the weekend. The team got that car back together. Goes a lap down here in the early stages of this race, but we've got to move for third. Daniel Worad to the inside of Taglianni.
Oh,
sometimes it helps when you don't know any better. Like some of the moves they make where the car just won't carry the momentum. But one thing I do know, and I've known for a long time, Dave, eight tires turn much better than four tires. And he just used Alex Tagliani to help through that turn.
And you know what? Daniel Morad, if you're a fan of Canadian motorsports, you know who Daniel Morad is. He's no stranger. He's a world champion go-kart racer. He's raced in Europe in the open-wheel cars, and he's done very well in the Porsche GT3 Cup here in Canada as well. So he knows his way around a racetrack.
Definitely is a veteran racer at this young age, but this is his first time in the full-size NASCAR stock car. Whoa,
man,
trouble.
Problems for White. Big problems. You can see damage to the back end. This is going to be a full course caution as White grabs the gear and gets going. He has tons of body damage to the back end of the Chevrolet. Sounds like oil is down in that corner.
Boy, those tire walls, once you get a piece of the tire wall, they just suck you in, and they eat the bodies apart on these fiberglass-bodied race cars, Dave.
That's going to be heartbreak for Jason White. He was just looking to keep a clean car and finish this one. Have a look at what happened.
And everything was normal. It just snapped around. And there he goes. Yep, back end first. Sucks in the front end. And lots of damage. He's lucky that car refired.
There's the 87 of Larry Jackson. Pulls down the safety lane into a stop. Another car is out. Todd?
46 car up in the air along pit road. A left axle is broken. That's the problem. Crew just telling the driver, shut it off. Brett Taylor looks like he's done for the day.
And if the left rear axle went anywhere, it would have gone out that axle cap, and all sorts of oil comes with it. Heavy rear end grease, and it is slick, Dave.
And there is the axle. You see it being picked up by the safety worker as they continue the cleanup here in the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto as we are under caution for the first time. A full course caution bunching the field and the work on the 21 of Jason White.
Rob McCollum and the rest of the YourGMCTruckStore.com crew going to work. There's almost nothing you can't do with duct tape, Dave.
And they'll get that body fixed up. It doesn't have to look pretty. It just has to hold together for the NASCAR officials to let them go. The 22 of John Ferrano has come to a stop in the Tower Events Dodge Challenger.
And this is Ferrano's first race since the last time we ran the Toronto Indy 5 years ago. Beautiful day here in Toronto for NASCAR on TSN.
On board with David Thorndike from Toronto. He's the first recipient of the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto free pass as we get set to return to green flag action.
Top running car, one lap down, and Dave Thorndike will hustle around the racetrack. He'll never catch the field before it goes to green, but he gets a pretty good head start.
And he gets back on the lead lap, which is a bonus there as the field bunches up side by side. Again, through this tight complex, the turn 10 into turn 11. We're riding on board. Gary Klute looking for the green flag on the front straightaway. Sean Gibbs with it in hand. He'll wave it. We're back underway.
Great start for Andrew Ranger up the inside. This time he's defending the bottom groove to make sure Daniel Morad doesn't slip up the inside. Ranger leads him out of turn number one, and Daniel Morad gets a great drive off the turn.
I thought I saw contact there between the 06 of Daniel Morad and the 18 of Alex Tagliani. Is those two racing for the same piece of real estate down the Lakeshore Boulevard here in the turn number three.
And just like before, we see the top four distance themselves a little bit from the battle for fifth with Kerry Mix and Jason Hathaway.
Well, Mix got a little crooked there in that Avenue Auto Parts 02, and there he made contact with the Rebestos number three of Jason Hathaway.
These guys are racing hard early on. This is the closest sniff that Kerry Mix and Jason Hathaway have had of the top four. The race went without a yellow up to that point. The top four had driven away, Dave. You give Jason Hathaway and Kerry Mix a look at the front of the pack, they're going to be driving hard.
But it is still Andrew Ranger in the Mopar Dodge in command. But don't look now. Here comes Daniel Morad to the inside.
That is a tough place to try to make a move. Again, Daniel Morad's inexperience paying dividends today.
You can't pass there. You can't tell me I can't pass there as Daniel Morad tried to stick it for the lead in the InSync Healthcare System 06. What a first race he's having.
And young Daniel Morad is learning each and every lap he races with the best in the business. Todd is in the pits with a report on the winner from Autodrome Chaudière.
Guys, the 32 team getting a bit of a break right now. It was a 12-hour day yesterday to make repairs to that car after the crash in qualifying. Alex LeBay told me just got some moisture, carried him into the tire wall, destroyed the left side of that car. Randy Smith says now he's in control and just working it out on course. Hasn't said a word on the radio, but the team deserves a lot of credit for getting those repairs done.
Absolutely, Todd. Hats off to that team. And to think, both cars from that team are running inside the top 11.
And one of the first people to pull their sleeves up and go to work was Alex LeBay himself. Did a lot of the work on that race car. He went back to the hotel about 11:30 to get some sleep for the race while the crew continued to work.
And there's a good look at young Caden Lapcevic. Second in points coming into this race in the Bay King Chrysler-sponsored entry. And he's having a very consistent run, currently sitting in 12th.
And that's what he's done all year. When he's not battling for wins on the ovals, he's getting better every lap on the road courses. Really makes the most of the opportunities he gets lap after lap and keeps all four fenders on the race car.
Halfway is the cross flag shown to the race leader, Andrew Ranger. And there is Robin Buck in the number one, taking a look on the 47, the WeatherTech Dodge of LP Dumoulin.
And Robin Buck has made some nice advances from the start of this race, all the way up into the top 10. And he's one car that looks to be getting a little better as the race goes on.
And then we look out the front window of the 59 of Gary Klute to that battle for seventh between Buck in the one and the 47 of LP Dumoulin.
And Buck with a great run up into turn number three. He's on the bottom, one of the best there is under braking, and he'll make that move. But Dave, the start of this race, the top four drove away. We saw first all the way back to about 12th, all in a tight bunch.
Absolutely, and Robin Buck in that cool green number one is one of them. Who says green on a race car is bad luck? Not Robin Buck here today, but problems for the nine of Adam Martin.
Adam Martin looks to have found the runoff area. Nope, and there he's found the concrete barrier as he backs up the Johnsonville number nine to get back onto the racetrack.
No caution as we continue under green. And there's a good look at his teammate, the 0-2 of Kerry Mix, the Avenue Auto Parts Ford Fusion, who's having a great run well inside the top 10 here today.
I can't tell you how pleased I am to see the Bulldog working through the field. One of the most exciting drivers this series has ever seen. And it's a better race when Kerry Mix is near the front.
And he's sitting in the sixth position, chasing the number three of Jason Hathaway as Hathaway does battle with the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. As you mentioned, there really is no shortage of racing all through this field as they work their way into lap traffic again.
And David Thorndike looks to have gone another lap down. He got the free pass, got about half a track out. Here goes Daniel Mora to the inside of turn three.
Where did he come from, says Andrew Ranger, and he goes to the lead. Daniel Mora in the NSYNC 06 in his very first race, the third leader of the afternoon here in the Pinty's Grand Prix at Toronto.
All of these drivers skating across the racetrack. The new has definitely worn off these Goodyear racing tires, and now they got to manhandle their cars. Look at Andrew Ranger, one of the smoothest drivers there is, and his hands are really working inside the car.
You know, we should talk a little bit about the track surface here at the Exhibition Place grounds. I mean, these are public roads 95% of the year. They close them about a week before this track is constructed, and there are streetcars driving on it. Some of these are parking lots, so they're rough in a lot of spaces. Lakeshore Boulevard is probably the smoothest area of this facility.
Dave, you're absolutely right. As we look on board, and you can see it in this screen, you go from pavement to concrete, back to pavement again. It's a huge challenge for these race car drivers, but they're the best racers there are.
Daniel Morad is your leader. We'll take a quick break. Daniel Morad leads in front of a hometown crowd on the streets of Toronto in his first ever NASCAR race. But did you see Andrew Ranger miss the breaking point in turn number three, and that'll cost him second place.
Overshot the corner ever so slightly, but that's all the mistake Alex Tagliani needed to squirt through into the second spot.
And we haven't really talked a lot about Alex Tagliani, but he qualified inside the top five as we'll take another look at this pass.
On board with Tag, they're all just going into the corner. And yeah, the bottom lane, that's the racing groove, open right up, makes the pass and slams the door.
Tag probably thought to himself, there's no way it can be that easy to pass Andrew Ranger here.
And we should explain, when we say slam the door, we've used that term a few times. Tagliani got into the racing line, got around Ranger, and you have to get back to the racing line. So you slam the door from the other driver getting to the line before you do, and that's how he completes the pass for second spot.
Talking about how good that 18 car has been in 2016 in the NASCAR Pinty Series, you'll remember he missed race number one at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park as he takes a peek for the lead here into turn number three. But he missed that race, and he's still in ninth place in the points, believe it or not. That's how good Tagliani's been.
Especially on these road courses, Dave. And there's a great look at the battle for fourth. Kevin Lacroix has fallen back from the lead trio into the grips of Jason Hathaway in the Robesto's Fast Eddie number three.
And there they work out of turn number two onto the backstretch. This back to the battle for the lead. The top three all covered by a blanket. The 06 of Daniel Morad, the 18 of Alex Tagliani, and the 27 of Andrew Ranger. Look at Alex Tagliani working that wheel. It looks like it's on cruise control and you're driving on the Gardner Expressway that borders this race facility in downtown Toronto. Tagliani takes a peek that time, but he, being a veteran, knows that Andrew Ranger's right there. If you make too much of a move, it's going to cost you a spot.
You have to make an offensive, aggressive move on the leader while being defensive enough to not allow the car behind it the opportunity. So Alex Tagliani right now sizing things up with Daniel Morad.
Car owner Colin Livingston, no doubt watching from pit lane and cheering on his driver as he once again works through turn number three. And he just fills that mirror of Daniel Morad. He's getting into his head.
Speaking of Colin Livingston, we're about to go out west. Oh, Daniel Morad out into the tire wall. There goes Alex Tagliani, Ranger into second. Daniel Morad, that could have been much, much worse as he's dragging some signage around the racetrack.
Tarp from the tire wall, but you mentioned it earlier, how quickly those tires can come up and bite you, and bite Daniel Morad they did as the debris falls onto the racetrack. Have another look at what happened.
Morad heavy braking down into the corner. Everything is, oh, you can see the front end just pushed up the racetrack. Tagliani goes by, Ranger goes by, Morad back to third.
Now keep in mind, Daniel Morad normally drives a Porsche GT3 Cup. If that was his Porsche, his race would be done, but here he still sits in third.
Hathaway with a big pass for fourth. Oh, and he loses the back end into turn number three. Was he able to keep the car running, losing positions out of the top 10, trying to get the car to turn over?
So frustrating as you're walking and watching the field go by. Jason Hathaway still trying to fire the Chevy, and now he gets it going and grabs the gear, but not before most of the field has passed him by.
Lost a lot of positions there as we look back to the battle for the lead between Tagliani in the 18 and Andrew Ranger in the 27.
It's really a two-horse race now at the front of the field as Daniel Morad has dropped off the pace just a little bit. As you look back just a little bit further, this is a tight-knit battle between the 02 of Kerry Mix, who sits in sixth spot, and a number of drivers chasing him.
That's sixth all the way back to 10th. We've got the son and the father, Gary Klutz in the 49, Peter Klutz in the 42.
Robin Buck takes a look on the Total Lubricants number 74 of Kevin Lacroix, and Dumoulin did the same thing on Kerry Mix, but everybody erring on the side of caution and getting back in line.
He was not pleased with the horsepower that the 47 was putting out. They went to an engine dyno, had some specialists look at some things with that engine package, and of course he's got Ron Beauchamp Sr. working with things under the hood on the 47. They found some more horsepower, so he was quite excited to come here to Toronto and see how it would play out.
And he qualified pretty well in seventh position, has been running inside the top 10, hovering around the top five all day long, as Ranger has now closed the gap back up on the 18 of Alex Tagliani.
I started to say a few minutes ago, we're going to the hometown of Alex Tagliani's car owner, Colin Livingston. I happen to know Livingston has a racing simulator. I don't know where it is. Is it a business or a shop? But I've heard it's really cool. Dave, I'm going to try to slip over there, get myself invited, and turn some laps.
He races go-karts, too, on Wednesday night. Maybe you should try and get a ride in that.
I don't mean to brag, but I also iRace with him a little bit online through the winter.
He beats you, doesn't he?
That's why I didn't mean to brag.
Fourth spot, we ride on board Kevin Lacroix, looking back to the number one of Robin Buck. Another solid run being put in by the veteran of Buck on the outside. If Kevin Lacroix, and he will take over that position.
I don't know about that. Lacroix trying to close the door. He will.
The lap car, the 21 of Jason White, is in the middle there. And now Buck has problems. Smoke from the back end of that Dodge Challenger.
And the problems are on the left front corner of that Dodge Dealers of Ontario Advertising Association sponsored number one. It looks like his chances at a top five finish all but done.
Let's have another look. Did he catch the wall?
Absolutely.
He was trying to squeeze past the lap car of Jason White, and White was giving him plenty of room. Those two teammates for the weekend as Robin Buck finds pit lane.
And you can't say anybody squeezed him. That was the inside wall. It just shows you how challenging this street circuit is, Dave.
And now back to the racing. There's the 47 of Dumoulin taking over fifth spot from the 02 of Kerry Mix. Gary Klute in the Pioneer Family Pools, number 59. He'll also get by.
A little bit of contact between Klute and Mix.
And tire wire and concrete wall for Klute.
Well, Mix returned the favor there. Kerry Mix gave Gary a push, and here comes Father Peter Klute.
And when you're sandwiched between father and son on the racetrack, you don't want to do that. Problems on the 71. Patrick Dussault, a frustrating afternoon.
He is.
Comes to an end. There's another car in there, too.
That is the 8 of Kevin Poitras. They are wedged into the wall. Significant damage to the front of Dussault's number 71.
Yeah, so the full course caution is displayed by starter Sean Gibbs, and this will give everybody a chance to catch their breath and regroup as we'll make a mad dash to the finish. You see all the debris on the racetrack as the racers pick and choose their way around.
Look at how we talk about how challenging the racetrack is. We haven't talked about the challenge these drivers have with visibility from these cars. Let's have a look at what happened. There you see at the top of the screen, they get together, Dussault and Kevin Poitras, and just the momentum with the two of them knocking wheels together, it just pushed them up into the wall, and then the wall does the rest, Dave.
And unfortunately for them, it looks like both of their afternoons will come to a conclusion as the field continues under caution. A good look at two who've been jousting for the last couple of laps, the 02 of Kerry Mix and the 59 of Gary Klute. Let's have another look.
So Kerry Mix into the left rear corner of Klute, carries him right up into the tire wall. And as we said, he's got to be cautious because he's got Gary's father, Peter Klute, right behind him. Now with NASCAR scoring, Dave, Gary Klute had gotten around Kerry, but with NASCAR scoring, Kerry will get the spot back for the restart here in Toronto.
There's been nonstop action on the track here in Toronto and at the Pinty's Trackside Grill. The Pinty's ambassadors have been handing out great tasting samples all weekend long. But you think the hot sauce has bite? Wait till you see this green, white, checkered finish we're setting up for.
We go on board with Jason White, the number 21. He's the free pass recipient. And Todd Lewis is pit side with a couple of masterminds for the drivers who will restart on the front row.
All right, let's check in with the crew chiefs before we go back to green. Tyler Case, crew chief for Alex Taglianni. Are you going to be the winning team?
We sure hope so. The EpiPen Chevy's been really good. Two world-class drivers. It's going to be a great battle.
Okay, that's the view from the 18 team. Dave White is the crew chief for Andrew Ranger. Can you be the winning team here today to get victory number three this season?
I know. It'd be really great to get victory number three with our Mopar Dodge. But we're points racing today. We need to finish well in the points. The championship's our big picture. 18's a little scary sometimes, so they've already informed me. But we'll be there. Never know what happens.
It'll be fun to watch for all of us, guys. We're getting ready to go green.
And Tyler Case and the whole 18 crew did a ton of work on this race car since iCar. They went through everything to make changes to make Alex Taglianni happier with the race car, Dave.
Is he happier? We will find out as we get set to go back to green. It's a green, white, checkered finish here in Toronto.
Huge restart for Taglianni. Ranger immediately drives to the inside looking for opportunity into turn one. Tires like crazy. He restarted towards the front, but lost a lot.
tumble backwards. A race leader from earlier on here in the Grand Prix of Toronto is now struggling in the late going.
We look at the top four. They've strung themselves up just a little bit. They're heading for the white flag, Dave. One more lap to get it done.
And there goes Clute in the CTL. Dodge the number 59. Sixth spot for the youngster. And problems for Cathcart as he goes for a slide and backs it into the tire wall.
Had a Martin out there as well. Both drivers carry on. One more lap to go on the streets of Toronto.
Brian Cathcart in the one last kick of the can tour along with Derek Lynch behind the wheel of that number 75. He gets going, so there's no caution. You saw the white flag for Alex Taglianni.
Andrew Ranger trails by about four car lengths. Contact between Jean-Francois Dumoulin in the 04 and Jason Hathaway in the 3 as they battle for 10th.
The Spectra premium driver, the 04 Dumoulin, picks up that spot. And now we ride on board with Hathaway.
Here's a look at the battle for the lead. Alex Taglianni has stretched out the advantage into turn 3. How about Caden Lapcevic in the 76? He is into the top 10.
Barely a mark on that car as he's had a great afternoon, done exactly what he's needed to do, and now Morad has found some fire once again in the 06 as he took a look underneath the 59 of Gary Clute.
Whoa! Contact between Josh Collins and the 25. Not sure who else was involved with him.
Big damage to the front end of the 25 of Collins, though.
Here comes Ranger. He's closing in with 3 quarters to go.
And Ranger will have one last try at it through turn number 10 and into turn 11 on the back bumper of Alex Taglianni. It's the number 27 of Andrew Ranger. Taglianni hits his marks. Down the front chute they go. Twin checkered flag.
Move, but Alex Taglianni was flawless on that final lap.
And Todd, how's that party in the pits?
There's a big celebration for the 18th team. Tyler Case, how satisfying is victory number 2 this season?
Oh, it's great. I got one of the best drivers in the world in this car. EpiPen, Raya Bell, all our sponsors, a great crew here with me. It's just, we won Toronto Indy. That's the best part of it.
Go celebrate with your driver.
Todd, they're all celebrating. A big thumbs up from Alex Taglianni. We'll be back to victory lane. Forty-three-year-old Alex Taglianni scores his fourth NASCAR win in 39 starts, and Todd standing by in the Pinty's winner circle.
Welcome back to Exhibition Place. Alex Taglianni is climbing out of that number 18 Chevrolet, standing up, a thumbs up, and waving the checkered flag to mark a successful return to the streets of Toronto. Alex Taglianni started on the outside of row number 1. It was a battle all day long for you, holding on to the end to capture the victory today.
Yeah, it was great. Obviously, the 22 racing team with Scott taking care of the boys and all the boys working so hard. We had a really bad race in iCar, and they stepped it up, and we brought a car here that was amazing. So thanks to those guys. The battle on the track was amazing. You know, newcomers not realizing how early you have to jump on the brakes, but we managed to keep that EpiPen number 18 car in one piece and bring it to victory lane.
Successful return to the streets of Toronto for Alex Taglianni, the winner this afternoon.
And there you see big high five between Tyler Case and car owner Colin Livingston as the celebration continues in victory lane.
And what a win it was. What a battle, Dave.
Let's take a look at the top 20 finishers here. You see great runs being put in. Kerry Mix inside the top 5. Daniel Morad salvaged a 7th place finish. Caden Lapcevic in 8th.
Looks like the Lapceviches will be headed west after all. Matthew Scannell finishes 13th, and how about the 46 of Brett Taylor overcomes adversity to finish 19th.
Now let's head back down trackside to Todd with your second place finisher.
Andrew, battle all afternoon. Second place result, a good finish for the number 2017.
It is, you know, it's a great race, actually. We are fighting all race long with Alex, and it was fun, you know. On the restart, I have a little problem to keep the momentum, but the moment where the
the pressure came on the tire, I was able to catch the guys. And we lead laps, great for Mopar, Penzel. I want to thank my team, everybody. We are leading the championship, so this is awesome.
In control of the championship, Andrew Ranger.
Speaking of the championship, a big shakeup in the point standings. Alex Tagliani goes from 9th up to 4th. DJ Kennington from 3rd all the way back to 6th.
And the top of the chart still look the same. Andrew Ranger out top, now with a 13-point advantage over Caden Lapcevich. And the driver who finished 3rd today is 3rd in the standings. Todd standing by.
Kevin Lacroix, podium result. It was a battle out there on the streets. This is what the kind of stock car racing we were expecting today.
Yeah, that's the kind of race I want. I like stock car racing at its best. So it was very nice to keep fighting with Andrew and Tag all race long. And in the last car, last laps, it was good. The bumper-to-bumper car was good. Losing had not so much front straight speed, but I kept fighting in the corners, and I was hoping for a crash at the end, but you know, they're intelligent, so the race was good, and I'm happy with the third.
Very good third place result for Kevin Lacroix here in Toronto.
And it's great to see all three drivers understand what a great show it was as event promoter Kevin Savary and now Tony Spiteri from Pinty's go in to congratulate Alex Tagliani on a win and a heck of a show.
The Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto has been brought to you by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn, by Leland Industries, a proud Canadian fastener company, and by Honeygoo from CleanFlow on Honey of a Lube.
These drivers and teams will take time to celebrate a fantastic race on the streets of Toronto, and then it's time to head west, Dave. Next stop, Edmonton, Alberta.
And the Alberta has new energy, 300. It's back up to a tight oval from a street course here in Toronto, but what an exciting afternoon it's been. Right from the drop of the green flag, we saw a land rush start, we saw contact, fire, we had it all.
We did have it all, and it's so good to be back at Toronto at one of the biggest races in the country.
And this is what NASCAR racing in Canada is all about, and you can expect to see more of it as we finish off the 2016 season. From all of us at Fuel Media Lab, we'll see you next time.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our fans for your support, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.